Colby Covington maintain status as one of the best welterweights though?
He is absolutely one of the best welterweights in the world. A lot of times people mistake the talk and the persona for Colby not being able to be a fighter. Colby Covington is a fantastic fighter, and he will get in your face from the moment they're official, or the moment the referee says fight, and the pace, and the cardio, and the work rate that he will push on his opponents is enough to break guys. Guys that are traditionally known as phenomenal cardio fighters like Rafael Dos Anjos melt under Colby Covington. He is a great fighter and a very, very hard worker.
Colby Covington steps inside the octagon. He looks ready to go. Undisputed UFC welterweight champion Leon Rocky Edwards. Obviously, there weren't many people picking him to beat Kamaru Usman at UFC 278. But that fight was scheduled for 25 minutes. He needed all of them. He produced one of the greatest highlights in UFC history.
He needed 24 minutes and 30 seconds in order to become the champion. But he never gave up on himself. It seemed as though everything was trending in the wrong direction and he got the job done. Leon Edwards is a phenomenal fighter. He's very well-rounded, and he's real big for the weight class. And you see his physicality come into play in that first round against Kamaru Usman, taking him down and controlling him on the ground.
Right.
But tonight he has a different challenge. He doesn't have the guy that brings all the accolades. He has a young, hungry lion that's looking to knock him off his throne.
And we will see how Leon handles this challenge, but of course, increased eyeballs on Leon Edwards, given what he was able to accomplish in becoming the man at 170 pounds. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight championship fight. All right, to get us started with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the challenger, Colby Chaos Covington. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky Edwards.
Herb Dean, our referee for this one.
Ready.
All right, well, this arena is absolutely deafening. As you might expect, Leon Edwards has finally signed on the dotted line, welcoming the challenge of number one contender, Colby Chaos Covington. Lands a big elbow there. Nice jab there by Covington. He's a guy who will wow you with pace and pressure, whether he's wrestling or striking.
Yeah, I mean, it's his calling card, right? His calling card is for him to really dictate the pace, really push the pressure on you, and hope that his opponents will look under the pressure that he puts.
All right, so perhaps he's going to have to address something defensively. There is a legitimate cut around his eye.
Yeah, he cut on the eye from that last strike. He's got a pinch. It now before it gets worse. Take it for a ride. Nice double leg. Nice finish.
And now is where things could get really interesting.
Got tagged a couple times. Nice combo up top. He landed it perfectly. Perfect placement. Perfect position. What a huge blow and a big moment in this fight.
Came with inches right there. Good night if that landed.
And has a great double leg. My goodness, he has a great double leg.
Well, he rocked him, but couldn't finish.
He rocked him, he hurt him bad. He couldn't find that one shot to close the door. Could not shut the lights off. And now, he's tapped to try to find that shot again.
All right, so the big storyline in this one, his offensive prowess, particularly when it comes to landing those hooks. And I know you'd like to play Tony Romo. You think he goes back to it here?
I am almost certain that he's going to go back to that specific punch because it's landing every time he's thrown it. And as the fight has gone on, it is landing with more force, and his opponent is starting to wear down. So I will not be surprised if we see another one that ends a fight.
Oh, beautiful striking there by Leon Edwards. He has really become a well-rounded check lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
As his opponent postures up, he opens it. Oh, big shots raining down.
Now he's postured up. He's got him stacked up. His opponent better move, or the referee is going to stop this fight.
Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions.
Covington's in half guard. Now drops inside that closed guard, DC.
Full guard. He's attacking guillotine. Yep, that guillotine's deep.
Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. So back to the stool, mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, here we go with the start of round two. Leon Edwards versus Colby Covington.
Get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
That is gonna do it! Leon Edwards has done it! Bruce Buffer has your official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 28 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky